All right, I'm Captain Proskimer of the Jacksonville Fire Rescue Department. I'm here with Scott with Glenn County Fire. They responded to a fire last night around 4 a.m. to the chemical plant. We're dealing with a chemical that is hydrogen peroxide pinene. They initially responded with three engines, a squad, a truck, a rescue, and a battalion chief. Battalion chief realized early on that they needed further resources. He called for further resources. They set up foam evolutions, deluge systems, and fought the fire for nearly 2 hours. Just prior to them arriving, there was an explosion. They continued to fight fire until the on-site water supply diminished. There was 1.3 million gallons of water on site, but it diminished, forcing crews to back up and be pulled away from the scene. After that, there was two additional explosions. I can tell you that at this point, no civilians have been injured. We have one firefighter who was taken to the hospital for exhaustion. That firefighter is in stable condition. We have two neighborhoods to the west that have been, they were initially sheltered in place. They've been further evacuated. The Camden County has evacuated the Dover Bluff area. We have two schools to the west that are 2.3 miles away. They are being sheltered in place. The south side of the port was evacuated at about 6:30 a.m. Obviously, you can tell by behind me, we're working with multiple agencies. I can't name them all, but you know, we're including the Georgia EPD, the Coast Guard, the Natural Resources. We have the Hazardous Materials Team from Jacksonville. We have the Hazardous Materials Team from Savannah. And we're all working together. It's way too early to determine the cause of this fire, so please don't even ask. We're working on, right now, the hazmat teams are working together to get in closer to determine what further efforts need to be done, if there's going to be further evacuations necessary. It's something that right now nobody's in severe danger, so they're not being too aggressive with it because this is a volatile chemical. Once all the evacuations are finished and people can return to place, each of the agencies will push out through social media that it's safe to get back to the areas needed. With that, I have multiple representatives, and I know you've got multiple questions. We'll answer any questions that we possibly can.
So how do you know that these chemicals are hazardous? So I'm assuming that's why you're evacuating people, because it's hazardous to people's health?
Absolutely. I mean, we have hazmat teams. It's known, you know, the plant knows, everybody knows that they're hazardous, but when they're in the plant, they're contained. They're not an issue. When you have a fire and you've got plumes of smoke, then they dissipate and you have to take all the precautions for the public. And right now, the public is our main focus. We want to make sure that everybody's safe, that nobody's going to have any issues whatsoever. So we will evacuate more than we need to evacuate. And I know it's a big inconvenience to the people, but it's the right thing to do for health and safety reasons. At this time, well, I'm going to say no. I mean, they're monitoring. We monitor the air, we monitor the area, and we've taken, you know, we got even the weather services here to tell us the winds and where we need to, the plumes are going to go. We're not active currently, right now, we're not actively with big plumes of smoke, so it's not as much of an issue. The fire's not under control. I'd like to say it was under control, but it's not at this time. They're not actively fighting it. The hazmat teams are making their approach in a cautious, safe way to determine what's the next step that we need to do.
Do you know what chemical it is? Obviously, if hazmat's here, they have to take specific precautions for specific chemicals.
Correct.
And do you know what's burning there now?
Well, yeah, the main chemical that we're dealing with is hydrogen peroxide pyrene. Pinene.
Do you know what it's used in?
What is it used in?
This chemical is used as an intermediate to prepare fragrance ingredients. For example, linalool oil as one of the examples. So that's what it's good for.
Did everybody get that? It's used in fragrances.
It's
primarily in fragrances.